Hello everyone, my name is Priyanka Shahane. I am working as assistant professor in Artificial Intelligence and Data Science Engineering Department of AIISS Institute of Information Technology. In this video, we are going to study Bresenham's line drawing algorithm. Bresenham's algorithm is used to generate lines. This algorithm is invented by Jack Bresenham and hence the name is Bresenham's line drawing algorithm. In Bresenham's algorithm, coordinates of starting point of the line and ending point of the line are given to us. You can see in this figure, A is the starting point of the line and its coordinates are x0, y0. B is the ending point of the line and its coordinates are xn, yn. The line is made up of number of points, or we can say pixels. And in Bresenham's line drawing algorithm, our goal is to find out the coordinates of all the points between starting point A and ending point B in order to generate line AB. Now let us see steps to solve Bresenham's line drawing problem. For sake of simplicity, we first note down the coordinates of starting point and ending point given in our problem statement. Here x0 is x coordinate of starting point, y0 is y coordinate of starting point, xn is x coordinate of ending point, and yn is y coordinate of ending point. And our goal is to generate coordinates of all the points between the starting point and ending point of the line. Next step is to calculate value of delta x and delta y from the given input. These parameters are calculated by the standard formulas. Formula to calculate value of delta x is xn minus x0. Here xn is x coordinate of ending point of the line, x0 is x coordinate of starting point of the line. Similarly, formula to calculate delta y is yn minus y0. Here yn is y coordinate of ending point of the line and y0 is y coordinate of starting point of the line. Now our next step is to calculate value of decision parameter pk, and it is calculated by the standard equation 2 into delta y minus delta x. Here pk tells us where to plot the next point of the line. Then we suppose the coordinates of our current point as xk, yk and coordinates of next point to be plotted by us as xk plus 1, yk plus 1. We find the next point based on value of decision parameter pk. Based on the value of pk, there are two conditions. First condition is value of pk is less than 0, and second condition is value of pk is greater than or equal to 0. If value of pk is less than 0, at that time we use these formulas in order to calculate value of next decision parameter pk plus 1, x coordinate of next point to be plotted by us, that is xk plus 1, and y coordinate of next point to be plotted by us, that is yk plus 1. Formula to calculate value of next decision parameter pk plus 1 is pk plus 2 into delta y. Here value of pk, that is current decision parameter, is already calculated by us in our previous step. You can see over here, we have calculated value of pk in step 3 by equation 2 into delta y minus delta x. So we just put that value of pk over here. Also, delta y is already calculated by us in the step 2 using equation yn minus y0. So we put that value of delta y in this equation. Formula to calculate value of x coordinate of next point to be plotted by us is xk plus 1. Here xk is value of x coordinate of our current point. Formula to calculate y coordinate of next point to be plotted by us is yk. Here yk is value of y coordinate of our current point. And when value of pk is greater than or equal to 0, at that time we have to apply this set of formulas in order to calculate value of next decision parameter, x coordinate of next point to be plotted by us and y coordinate of next point to be plotted by us. Now our next step is to keep repeating step 4 until the end point is reached or number of iterations equal to delta x minus 1 times. Now let us see one problem based on Bresenham's line drawing algorithm. Our problem statement is calculate the points between starting coordinates 9, 18 and ending coordinates 14, 22. Here coordinates of starting point of the line and ending point of the line are given to us. We just write those coordinates in our standard format. Here x0, y0 indicates coordinates of starting point of the line and xn, yn indicates coordinates of ending point of the line. Now our next step is to calculate values of delta x and delta y. Standard formula to calculate value of delta x is xn minus x0. Values of xn and x0 are already given to us in our problem statement. Value of xn is 14 and value of x0 is 9. So we just put those values over here and we get output as 5. Standard formula to calculate value of delta y is yn minus y0. Values of yn and y0 are already given to us in our problem statement. You can see over here, value of yn is 22 and value of y0 is 18. So we just put those values over here and the output that we get is 4. Now our next step is to calculate value of decision parameter pk. Decision parameter decides where to plot the next point of the line, and formula to calculate value of pk is 2 into delta y minus delta x. Values of delta y and delta x are already calculated by us in step 2. Value of delta x is 5 and value of delta y is 4. So we just put those values over here and after solving this equation we get our output as 3. Therefore value of decision parameter pk is 3. Now our next step is to check the value of pk with respect to two conditions given in our algorithm. The two conditions for pk are value of pk less than 0 or value of pk greater than or equal to 0. When value of pk is less than 0, at that time we use this set of formulas in order to calculate value of next decision parameter, value of x coordinate of next point to be plotted by us and value of y coordinate of next point to be plotted by us. And when value of pk is greater than or equal to 0, at that time we use this set of formulas. In our case, value of pk is 3. It means it is greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, case 2 is satisfied and we have to use these formulas in order to calculate value of pk plus 1, xk plus 1 and yk plus 1. Formula to calculate value of pk plus 1, that is next decision parameter, is pk plus 2 into delta y minus 2 into delta x. Value of pk is already calculated by us in our previous step. You can see over here, value of pk is calculated in step 3 and it is 3. So we put 3 over here. Also value of delta y and delta x are already calculated by us in step 2. Value of delta x is 5 and value of delta y is 4. So we just put those values over here and after solving this equation we get our final output as 1. Similarly, formula to calculate value of x coordinate of next point to be plotted by us is xk plus 1. Here xk is value of x coordinate of our current point. Here our current point is x0, y0. So xk is 9, which is equal to x0. So we put that value over here and the output that we get is 10. Similarly, formula to calculate value of y coordinate of next point to be plotted by us is yk plus 1. Here yk is value of y coordinate of our current point. our current point is x0, y0, and value of y coordinate of our current point is 18. So we put 18 in our equation, and the value that we get for yk plus 1 is 19. Now next step is to keep repeating step 4 until the end point is reached, or number of iterations is equal to 4 times. Now let us see some of the advantages of Bresenham's line drawing algorithm. First advantage is it is easy to implement. Second advantage is it is fast and incremental. Third advantage is the points generated by this algorithm are more accurate than DD algorithm. And fourth advantage is it uses fixed point only. It do not deals with floating point numbers. Therefore, it is faster as compared to other algorithms. Now let us see some of the disadvantages of Bresenham's line drawing algorithm. First disadvantage is, though it improves the accuracy of generated points, but still the resulted line is not smooth. Second disadvantage is, this algorithm is for basic line drawing. Third disadvantage is, it cannot handle diminishing jaggies. These are the references. Thank you for watching.